کنوانسیون سراسری برای یک ایران دموکراتیک، محکومیت حمله موشکی به لیبرتی، ضرورت بازگرداندن مجاهدین به اشرف، تأکید بر شناسایی مقاومت ایران. واشنگتن، 9 فوریه 2013، 21 بهمن 91. سخنرانان: سناتور ریک سانتوروم، کاندیدای ریاست جمهوری، شهردار رودی جولیانی، ژنرال جیمز جونز، لی همیلتون رئیس پیشین کمیته خارجی کنگره از رهبران دموکرات ها، سناتور کی بیلی هاچیسون از رهبران ارشد جمهوری خواهان در سنای آمریکا، اندرو کارد رئیس ستاد رئیس جمهور جورج بوش، فرانسیس تانزند مشاور رئیس جمهور جورج بوش، وزیر مایکل موکیزی و پاتریک کندی.
Good morning, everybody. It's good to see so many familiar faces and friends. And today was set to be a celebration of the continuing struggle that all of you have waged for years on behalf of your family members and friends and the people of Iran who are seeking freedom. But today we're gathered at a time of great sorrow. Sorrow because the work that you have been endeavoring to do to prevent the kinds of tragedies that we've seen against the people of Ashraf in years past, so that we would never repeat those tragedies again, have come to pass where once again, last night, terrible tragedy befell the residents, the former residents of Ashraf, now confined to a camp that's called Liberty, but is anything but liberty for the people living there. So last night, in spite of a lot of work that many of you have endeavored in promoting their safety and protection, in spite of repeated calls on the United Nations and the United States to fulfill our commitment to the people of Camp Ashraf, in spite of all of that, we are reminded again today that we have work to do to keep further tragedies like the one that happened last night from ever happening again. And that is why we're here today. I'd like to now read the names of the six that were killed last night. Added to the list of martyrs. And when I finish reading their names, I'd like to ask all of you to join me in paying tribute to their spirit, because these were true martyrs who knew that their lives were always in jeopardy, but nonetheless carried their fight so that their people, their country could be free. So when I conclude reading these names, I'd like to ask all of you to stand and join me in a moment of applause for their lives, for their sacrifice, and for the cause that they died for. Puran Najafi. Yaya Nazari. Mehdi Abedi. Mustafa Khosrati. Akbar Azizi. Hadi Shafihi. We are here today to make sure their lives were not lost in vain. We're here today to recommit ourselves to the cause that they died for. We're here today to once again say that no longer should the people of Iran be subject to a tyrannical dictatorship and theocracy that jeopardizes the lives of their very people, whether in Iran or in the world. And today we set forth that idea as our modus operandi. So we are mindful that these latest martyrs were given a promise by the United States government, were protected under the Fourth Geneva Convention, were given an assurance by the United States of America that they would be protected, and that was a promise that we made in writing. And whether this group, all of us, here in Washington, D.C., in our nation's capital, can stand by with the word of this country being violated, the commitment that the United States made to protect the people of Camp Liberty, and while we see them come under assault. My friends, liberty is a hoax. We need an action plan today. We need the United States to come out today and say they are for protecting, as they promised, the people of Camp Liberty, and that we're not going to let them have any more people die at the hands of the Iranian secret police and their collaborators in the Iraqi government. The United States has a responsibility to those six people who were killed. We have our word that we're going to protect them. And here we have two documents. We know about these documents, all of us now. Now that Mr. Boumediene left the United Nations and exposed the fact that in the draft survey of whether liberty was suitable for humanitarian purposes, this draft said, categorically that Camp Liberty was not suitable, was not safe. And in this document, signed on by people like Martin Kobler, the UN representative in charge of the protection of Camp Liberty, he verifies, the UN verifies that Liberty is safe. We know. We know now that the blood of those innocent martyrs that were killed last night are on Martin Kobler's hands today. Today, Martin Kobler ought to resign his position at the United Nations in disgrace. And the United States ought to take every step necessary today to ensure the protection of the people they promised to protect, whether that means returning them to a safer location in Camp Ashraf, which has an 80-mile protective barrier, because no longer can it be said that liberty is safe after what happened last night. Now it's my honor to introduce a great American, not only the mayor of the great city of New York, which came under a terrorist attack that we all know about, but also because of his response and the symbol that he created, he became known as a person of inspiration, and he's an inspiration in this cause as well, Mayor Rudy Giuliani.
Thank you very much, Patrick. Thank you. Today I came here to originally speak about the great achievement that you all accomplished in bringing about delisting and to talk about the conditions at Camp Liberty and about recognizing you as an alternative to the brutal regime in Iran. But today, tragically, we're forced to deal with something more immediate. Today, we're forced to deal with murder, cold-blooded murder that occurred just a few hours ago. Shame on the United Nations and shame on the United States Department of State. Shame on you! These murders this morning did not have to take place. They should not have taken place. There is no reason that they should have occurred. These people moved at the urging of the United Nations and the Secretary of State of the United States. They were under the protection of the United Nations and the United States. There was no reason for this move. We said that a year ago. There was no reason for it. These people were in Ashraf. These people could have been relocated from Ashraf to any number of countries. The relocation could have been done at Ashraf expeditiously and sensibly. There never was a reason for this move. But the United Nations, the United States Department of State, the Iraqi government insisted on it. About a year ago, in front of a gathering like this, I said that it looked like Camp Liberty would be a concentration camp. When I met on, I believe it was July 1st of 2012, with Martin Kubler in Paris, with Judge Mukasey present and a number of our colleagues, he was insulted that I called it a concentration camp. Well, Martin Kubler, it is not only a concentration camp, it's a killing field. And you, Martin Kubler, watched it become a concentration camp. You allowed it to become a concentration camp, and you permitted it to become a killing field, and the responsibility is directly on your hands. You shouldn't resign. Ban Ki-moon should fire you today! I am, Martin Kubler, I am personally outraged because you lied to me, you lied to Judge Mukasey, you lied right to our face. You lied to Madame Rajavi. You're a liar. And the blood of these people is on your hands. But, as Patrick Kennedy pointed out, responsibility is not just on the United Nations. Responsibility, unfortunately, and it breaks my heart to say this, is on my country as well. It's on the United States. First of all, when these people originally gave up their arms, they handed them over to the United States military. And as military leader after military leader has told you at conferences like this, they were promised, solemnly promised, the protection of the United States of America. Not just the United Nations, but of the United States of America. Over the years, the word of the United Nations has not meant much. It's been fairly useless as an organization in solving our world's disputes. But the word of the United States of America is solemn and precious. And that word has been broken over and over and again. These people were promised protection. Not only were they promised protection, but in October of 2011, Secretary Hillary Clinton told the United States Congress that America has a good plan, which is to move Camp Ashraf residents to Camp Liberty. Secretary Clinton, in her statement on December 25, 2011, regarding the relocation to Camp Liberty, stated that the United States, quote, welcomes this important step toward a humane resolution to the ongoing situation at Ashraf. The UN effort, she said, has our full support. She also stated that officials from the United States Embassy, Baghdad, will visit Camp Liberty regularly and frequently. They have not visited regularly and frequently. Not only has that promise been broken, but the most important promise has been broken. The promise to help keep these people safe. And when the attack took place this morning, and people were being murdered, and rockets were being fired into the camp, where was the United States to vindicate its promise of protection? Nowhere! Nowhere in sight. This is dishonorable. The United States must stand by its promise. The President of the United States should lead from the front, not from behind. If nothing less will suffice. Yes, move them to Ashraf. But we've seen them killed at Ashraf as well as at Liberty, haven't we? No. If our word means what it is supposed to mean, if the honor of the United States is to be vindicated, then the President of the United States must act forcefully and decisively. We have an obligation. There's no choice but to live up to our word, and nothing less will suffice. And then we should move on. We should move on to the agenda that has us here originally, which is to recognize this organization for what it is, the best hope for a free, democratic, decent, and non-nuclear Iran. I conclude by saying to those who are listening and will listen, from the families that have lost loved ones today, who have loved ones in hospitals, or maybe not even in hospitals, but wounded by this attack, our heart goes out to you, our prayers go to you, and most importantly, we've stood with you, but we stand with you now with even more conviction and with even more determination that these lives will not have been lost in vain. And it will lead, under the leadership of Madam Rajavi and your organization, to an Iran that is free, democratic, to an Iran that respects human rights, and to an Iran that is peaceful and non-nuclear. We double our commitment, we triple our commitment, and we will not rest until these goals are achieved. God bless you.